I'm April Kalloch and I work at Northwest Media. 3 years ago, we received a grant called Picturing America and we got 40 copies of art. And so we hung all of them in the media and we did a scavenger hunt. Then they had to find things in the pictures.
Nicholas, I didn't even see that. There's a rainbow.
And the kids had a blast with it. There's not a lot of thought, but it opened up a lot of things to them because they had to look at the art, not only just to find the things, but as they were looking, you could hear them talking. Oh my gosh, look at this. And it was really kind of cool listening to them. So since then, we've displayed 3 pieces of art with various things that they have to do with that art. And we create a corner of the media as a museum. Last year, I did the American flamingo. I did a stained glass by Tiffany and a portrait of Abraham Lincoln 4 days before he was shot. And they had to recreate the art. So one class, they did it all using technology. One class actually made a black suit and made the beard and took their own black and white photograph. So it was really kind of cool how they interpreted how to recreate things. So it was, last year was very exciting. Well, the museum this year is all about the 4 basic human freedoms. In January of 1941, we were on the brink of World War II. So the president made a speech about freedom from want, freedom of worship, freedom from fear, and freedom of speech. So I tried to tie all the pictures hanging in the museum that tie into those 4 basic freedoms. It's doing really well. Even the primary classes are going in, and I go in and give them a little talk about what it is and what freedoms are. So when they look at the pictures, they're supposed to look at that picture and decide which of those basic freedoms that I'm trying to portray to them.
Kirsten, what do you think he was thinking at this part of his life when it was dark?
What is freedom?
What is freedom? He was thinking about freedom?
Getting himself out of there, because when he's poor, somebody else owned him and he couldn't own himself.
Very good way to put it. I like that.
Some teachers go in and say, okay, this was done in whatever year it was. How old is that picture? Okay, this artist was born then. So they tie a little bit of math into it. And last year we tied geography into it also. So we try to tie more than one academic endeavor into it.
Who do you think this man is? Have you ever seen him before? Raina, have you seen him before?
He looks like George Washington.
He does look like George Washington. He is George Washington.
When they're in checking out a book, they wander into the museum and they look at the pictures, and I think that's helped fire up the excitement. And I have copies of all the questions with the pictures so they can think about it a little at a time versus the whole thing at once.
It's like the dark is like death and the light is life.
This is my favorite because it's so tall. And you can get outside on the roof.
Some children have come back on their own and worked really hard on it and are very proud of themselves when they get the connection.
I like the frame of speed because there's a lot of detail and you have to use your mind to think of what is happening.
Freedom of one, that's what I like. Because it's like you want something, and this mother, she has like a lot of kids, and she is like poor, I think.
Every year we do a contest, and this year it's called Artful Friday.
I liked coming to the art museum in the media because it was fun and it taught me things about history.
The reason that Kobe Fuller won our Picturing America contest was that she answered her questions completely with a lot of thought and insight into as to why, for example, the migrant mother may have looked the way she looked. She answered completely as to why her face was careworn, what she thought was going on in the mother's life.
When I see that picture, I think of speaking out and not letting things happen to you.
A medal!
Yeah, look what it says on the back. Can you read it?
You didn't bring a picture of America. When in 2012.
Yeah. I like what you wrote. You said the person who has a sad face and they have to go place to place finding food to eat.
Yeah.
We love art!
In the media center, when I saw all those pictures, that was pretty cool.